What you are looking at is a large and deep depression in the desert of southern New Mexico. If you look around this feature, known as the Kilbourne Hole, you will find many dark-colored rocks which distinguish this feature as not being a sinkhole or a nuclear test crater. Instead, these rocks are volcanic in origin, and this fact is supported by the adjacent eroded dark black lava flows from the Aden Crater's shield volcano. The fascinating Kilbourne Crater is also volcanic in origin, as it is in fact a type of volcanic explosion crater referred to as a MAR. It measures an impressive 12,580 feet long, 9,000 feet wide, and 440 feet deep. And within this crater are numerous pieces of Earth's mantle. What I'm referring to are green and greenish-yellow crystals known as olivine, with the gem variety of this mineral being known as peridot. The Kilbourne Hole is located in far southern New Mexico, where it is 25 miles south-southwest of the city of Las Cruces. The Kilbourne Hole is not simply an isolated feature, as to its south there are three other MARs, while an additional three more MARs are to its southwest. All of these vents are part of the same volcanic complex, which when combined with the numerous cinder cone vents and the Aden Crater shield volcano is known as the Potrillo volcanic field. While this volcanic field has not produced an eruption in more than 10,000 years, it likely will erupt again at some point in the future, perhaps distant future, and thus could best be classified as dormant. Just like the more than 300 cubic kilometer body of magma more than 10 miles deep in the crust and the potentially active Carrizozo volcano to the north-northeast, the Potrillo volcanic field exists due to a rift zone in the crust known as the Rio Grande Rift. Here, in parts of New Mexico and Colorado, the crust is very slowly spreading apart to the east and west. This spreading causes material in the mantle to more easily permeate through the crust, occasionally reaching the surface and forming a chain of infrequently erupting volcanoes. By the time the story of the Kilbourne Hole began, the Potrillo volcanic field had been erupting intermittently for approximately 1 million years. Approximately 24,000 years ago, a body of magma originating from the mantle began intruding into the crust via an already established path of least resistance. Along the way, this magma carried with it pieces from the mantle which included numerous olivine crystals. While this intrusion was ongoing, it likely created a series of small to moderate magnitude earthquakes which continually got shallower and shallower. Finally, the intruding batch of magma reached the underlying water table present in this section of New Mexico during the Ice Age. Due to the intense heat generated by the magma, it caused the large body of overlying groundwater to quickly flash to steam. Since the same massive steam takes up vastly more volume than the water it once was, it caused an immense amount of pressure to build. Eventually, this pressure reached a breaking point, causing a powerful explosion to shoot upwards with an energy release equivalent to the detonation of more than a megaton of TNT. As a several thousand foot wide patch of ground exploded, a Plinian eruption column shot more than 82,000 feet or 25 kilometers into the sky. Part of the eruption column then collapsed downwards, creating incinerating pyroclastic flows which swept across the Ice Age era landscape at a speed of more than 200 miles per hour and traveling up to 8 miles distant. Then, smaller eruptions began, causing a larger volume of lava rich in olivine crystals to be deposited onto the crater floor. As these smaller eruptions continued for several weeks, ash would continue to pile up, which, along with pyroclastic flow deposits, would total more than 40 feet thick on the newly formed crater rim. It would take perhaps decades for this ash to eventually cool, by which time the extent of the eruption which occurred had become clear. In total, at least 0.33 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock had erupted, meaning the eruption which formed Kilbourne Hole had a volcanic explosivity index rating of a 4 at a very minimum. As a final note, I want to mention that collecting any rocks and minerals, including olivine slash peridot, at the Kilbourne Hole is forbidden as the site is part of a national monument. Rock samples shown in this video were all presumably photographed on site and not removed outside of it. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.